Embark with me on this transformative journey, guided by the timeless wisdom of Stoicism. Together we'll explore how serenity, courage, and clarity can light our way, even through life's storms. This journey isn't just about learning to face challenges with resilience, but about discovering the art of living with purpose and inner peace. Are you ready to dive deep into these ancient teachings and apply them to your daily life? If so, I invite you to subscribe to the channel, leave your comments with reflections or questions, and of course, hit that like button if you find value in this journey. Let's unravel the path to a more fulfilling and authentic life, following in the footsteps of the wise Stoics. Mastery over emotions. Picture yourself standing atop a majestic mountain, gazing into the horizon. Around you, clouds of emotions form, transform, and dissipate. Just as Epictetus, an ancient philosopher, reveals to us, it's not the storms themselves that shake us, but rather our interpretations of them. Now take a moment to reflect. How powerful would it be if we could master the chaos of these internal storms, turning them into gentle breezes? Beginning our journey with mastery over our emotions is like blazing new trails on a mountain, where each step is a learning experience. The Stoics, with their ancient wisdom, encourage us not to be mere spectators of our emotional reactions. They challenge us to be the masters of our own minds, to face each internal turbulence, not with resistance, but with understanding and serenity. Why, then, allow internal storms to drag us into chaos? The truth is, we have the ability to observe them, recognize them, and let them pass without destabilizing us. Imagine each emotion as a passing cloud in the sky of your mind. You have the choice to fixate on one or simply watch it pass by. By practicing serenity in the face of emotional storms, we become stronger. We become like sturdy trees that, despite strong winds, remain firm, rooted in a land of self-awareness and understanding. Now I invite you to reflect. What storms have you allowed to drag you? What would your life be like if you learned to watch them pass by without being swept away? This is an invitation not just to self-awareness, but to personal power. It is a call for us to learn together to navigate the often turbulent waters of our emotions with wisdom and balance. Value control over what is controllable. Now imagine yourself as the captain of a ship, navigating through the vast seas of life. As Marcus Aurelius, a leader and thinker from ancient times, wisely and assertively guides us, our true power lies in recognizing what is under our command. In the tumultuous seas of existence, many are the waves and storms beyond our control. Yet the ship's helm, the direction we choose, is always in our hands. How liberating is it to understand this truth? By focusing our energy and attention on the sails we can adjust, we stop being playthings of the currents and start navigating with purpose and determination. This teaching, while simple, is revolutionary. It eliminates countless unnecessary worries from our lives, worries that often consume us without providing any benefit. I ask you, how many times have you found yourself consumed by situations beyond your control? How much effort have you wasted trying to change the unchangeable? The wisdom of Marcus Aurelius guides us to a path of greater inner peace and effectiveness. By concentrating our efforts in areas where we can truly make a difference, we not only optimize our impact in the world, but also find a rare and precious serenity. This principle invites us to deeply reflect on our daily actions and concerns. It challenges us to ask, is it within my power to control this? If the answer is no, we are encouraged to let go, to release that burden. But if the answer is yes, then we have a fertile field for our effort and creativity. The practice of this discernment not only makes us more centered and effective individuals, but also strengthens our sense of agency and responsibility. It empowers us to be architects of our own lives, consciously choosing where to place our energy and efforts. So, which areas of your life are waiting to be navigated with this new understanding? What would your existence be like if you started applying this powerful principle today? Resilience in the face of adversity. Now let's dive deeper into this journey, exploring a territory many consider challenging, yet is actually filled with opportunities. Control over what is within our grasp. Marcus Aurelius, not just a ruler of the Roman Empire, but also a profound thinker, guides us with a shining light through this reflection. He advises us to channel our energy and focus towards the areas of our lives over which we have influence. But what does this really mean in daily life? Imagine how liberating it is to divert attention from the storms we cannot control, and instead concentrate our forces on the actions within our reach. This not only saves us from unnecessary anguish, but also empowers us to act with more purpose and effectiveness. Instead of getting lost in a sea of worries about the uncontrollable, ask yourself, what can I improve right now? This simple question can be the beacon guiding your actions towards a safe harbor of achievement and inner peace. Moving forward on this journey, we encounter resilience in the face of adversity. Life, with its unpredictability, sometimes throws us into turbulent waves. However, adopting the Stoic perspective, each challenge becomes a step in our growth. Seneca, another wise man from antiquity, echoes this message by reminding us that we are forged in adversity. Every setback is, in fact, an invitation to strengthen our character and enhance our capacity for overcoming. So, faced with an obstacle, instead of asking, "Why is this happening to me?" why not rephrase the question to, "How can I grow from this?" This shift in perspective is powerful. It empowers us to see each difficulty not as a sign of defeat, but as a unique opportunity for personal development. Now I invite you to reflect on your own life. What challenges have you been facing? How can you turn them into opportunities for growth? Remember, every step, no matter how small, is progress in the direction of resilience and self-actualization. Simplicity and contentment. In a society marked by consumerism and the incessant pursuit of more goods, more status, more recognition, the proposition of simplicity and contentment emerges almost like an oasis in the desert. Pause for a moment and reflect. When was the last time you felt truly satisfied with what you had, without longing for something more? Simplicity, as taught by the Stoics, is not about deprivation or denial of the good things in life. Quite the contrary, it is about a deep appreciation for what is essential, for what truly matters. Imagine the freedom of not being enslaved by your desires for more, the peace of mind that comes from gratitude for the present. Doesn't that sound refreshing? But how can we cultivate this simplicity and contentment in our lives? First, it's essential to recognize the difference between need and desire. Needs are the basic requirements for a healthy and productive life, while desires are often shaped by external influences, such as advertising and social pressure. Making this distinction allows us to focus on what we genuinely need to live well, freeing us from the shackles of rampant consumption. True satisfaction, then, comes from this understanding and acceptance of enough. This doesn't mean you can't enjoy new experiences or acquire things that bring you joy. It means, however, valuing these things for what they add to your life, not for the status or image they represent to others. Now I invite you to perform an exercise. Look around and identify something you have for which you are genuinely grateful. It could be something as simple as a book that inspired you, a cup of coffee that comforts you in the mornings, or the company of a dear friend. Feeling this gratitude is the first step towards cultivating a sense of contentment. And remember, contentment does not mean complacency. It's about finding balance and happiness in your current state, while also recognizing and working towards your dreams and goals. But these goals are chosen consciously, not imposed by external expectations. Emotional self-sufficiency, simplicity and contentment, values so precious and at the same time so challenging to cultivate in our era of superabundance. We live bombarded by messages that encourage us always to want more, to seek the next purchase, the next gadget, the next trend. But deep down, have you ever felt that emptiness that emerges after acquiring something you desired greatly? This feeling is a sign, a reminder that true satisfaction doesn't lie in what we possess, but in a state of contentment with what we have. The Stoics, wise men of antiquity, left us a powerful teaching on the art of living well. They show us that simplicity isn't about deprivation, but about celebrating the essential, about finding joy and gratitude in the most basic things of life. Have you ever stopped to consider the beauty of a sunset, the smile of a child, the tranquility of a peaceful afternoon? These seemingly simple moments carry within them the essence of true happiness. Now imagine for a moment your life stripped of excesses, where each object, each activity, each choice is made with intention and purpose. Doesn't that sound liberating? Simplicity offers us that freedom. The freedom to unshackle ourselves from the chains of consumerism and find contentment in what truly matters. But what about emotional self-sufficiency? Ah, this is a treasure that the Stoics teach us to cultivate with great care. Emotional dependency, whether on people, circumstances, or material goods, is like being in a boat adrift, at the mercy of waves and storms. In contrast, emotional self-sufficiency is like building a firm and solid lighthouse within oneself, a safe haven where life's storms cannot reach. Cultivating this inner fortress doesn't mean isolating oneself or becoming indifferent, but rather learning to find peace and joy within oneself, regardless of what happens around you. Imagine how powerful it is to be able to say, "I have everything I need within me." That is true freedom. The freedom not to be shaken by external storms, because you have a center of calm and strength within you. So how do we start this journey towards simplicity, contentment, and emotional self-sufficiency? It begins with the choice to look inward, to value what we have, to practice gratitude, and to strengthen our inner world. Small daily practices like meditation, reflection, and gratitude can be the first steps in this direction. The practice of reflection. As we navigate the ceaseless current of desires and needs imposed by our modern society, simplicity emerges as a beacon of clarity and tranquility. It's a gentle invitation to slow down, take a deep breath, and appreciate the essence of what truly matters in life. But how can we cultivate this simplicity and find genuine contentment in a world flooded with stimuli that constantly feed our desire for more? The answer, though challenging, lies in the timeless wisdom of the Stoics. They teach us that true satisfaction isn't a trophy won through the incessant accumulation of material goods, but rather a sense of fulfillment that springs from recognizing and being grateful for what we already have. Pause for a moment and reflect. When was the last time you felt truly grateful for the simple fact of being alive, for the food on your table, the roof over your head, or the people around you? Yet, simplicity and contentment go beyond gratitude. They challenge us to reassess our priorities and recognize that many of the things we fervently pursue are in fact unnecessary for our happiness. What if, instead of always seeking the new, the fastest, the brightest, we focused on nurturing our relationships, appreciating moments of stillness, and fostering our inner growth. And here comes an equally revolutionary concept: emotional self-sufficiency. Imagine for a moment an unshakable fortress, not made of stone or metal, but of resilience and inner peace. This is the fortress the Stoics encourage us to build within ourselves. An emotional self-sufficiency that allows us to maintain our serenity even in the face of life's storms. Emotional dependency, on the other hand, is a chain that imprisons us, leaving us at the mercy of the external world's fluctuations. But how do we break these chains? The key to this freedom lies in the constant practice of reflection. By dedicating ourselves to daily introspection, we create space to evaluate our actions, thoughts, and emotions in an honest and constructive manner. This practice is not just an exercise in self-analysis, it's a pathway to align our lives with our highest principles, ensuring that every step we take is a step towards the best version of ourselves. So, I invite you to reflect. What can you do today to simplify your life? How can you cultivate greater emotional self-sufficiency? In what ways can the practice of reflection help you live in accordance with your deepest values? Empathy and community. At the core of Stoicism, there is a principle that is often overshadowed by the emphasis on self-sufficiency and individual resilience: the vital importance of empathy and community engagement. By exploring this facet, we discover that despite Stoic focus on strengthening the self, true fulfillment can only be achieved when we recognize our interconnectedness with others and the world around us. But what does it really mean to practice empathy, and how can it strengthen our communities? Practicing empathy goes far beyond simply feeling sorry for others. It's a conscious effort to understand others' experiences, emotions, and perspectives, putting oneself in their shoes. Have you ever stopped to think about how the world would be different if each of us took a moment to truly listen and understand the people around us? Empathy has the power to transform relationships, build bridges where there were once chasms, and promote mutual understanding that transcends cultural, social, and personal barriers. Furthermore, contributing to the well-being of the community is a natural extension of practicing empathy. It's not just an act of charity or assistance, but recognizing that we are part of a larger whole, and that collective well-being directly contributes to our individual well-being. When we act with the aim of improving our community, whether through small acts of kindness, volunteering, or social initiatives, we are actually cultivating an environment where everyone can thrive. Imagine for a moment a society where empathy and community engagement are core values, where each individual recognizes the impact of their actions on the collective and strives to contribute positively. This is the kind of society Stoicism encourages us to build, a community that values inner strength, but also recognizes the importance of reaching out and opening our hearts to others. So I ask you, how can you practice empathy more actively in your life? In what ways can you contribute to the well-being of your community? Remember that every gesture of understanding and every action aimed at the collective has the potential to create waves of positive change. Acceptance of the flow of life. The journey of life is filled with twists and turns, from moments of pure joy to periods of challenge and uncertainty. In this whirlwind of experiences, embracing the natural flow of life reveals itself not only as a survival strategy, but as a true act of freedom. But what does it truly mean to embrace this flow with all its ups and downs? Accepting the flow of life is recognizing that, despite our best efforts, there are forces beyond our control. It's understanding that life is a complex tapestry woven with threads of joys, sorrows, successes, and failures. Facing this reality with grace and courage allows us to navigate turbulent waters with a serenity that only comes from a deep understanding of our own resilience. Imagine for a moment that you are in a boat sailing down a river. There will be moments when the waters are calm and the journey is smooth. At other times, you will face rapids and storms. Trying to control the river is futile. It will follow its course with or without your approval. But what you can control is how you handle the helm, how you respond to the conditions of the river. This metaphor encapsulates the essence of accepting the flow of life. True freedom arises when we learn to differentiate between what is within our power to change and what is beyond it. Focusing our energy on our responses, attitudes, and actions in the face of various situations gives us a sense of agency and purpose. Furthermore, this acceptance allows us to live fully in the present, without becoming overly attached to the past or the future. But how can we cultivate this acceptance in our daily lives? Start by observing the moments when you feel resistant or frustrated with how things are unfolding. Ask yourself, can I change this situation? Or am I trying to control the uncontrollable? This simple reflection can pave the way for greater acceptance and inner peace. Additionally, practice gratitude. Focusing on the things we are grateful for, even in the most challenging moments, can help us maintain a balanced and positive perspective on life. Every experience, whether good or bad, carries with it a lesson, an opportunity for growth and transformation. Accepting the flow of life does not mean resignation or passivity. On the contrary, it is an invitation to embrace life with its full spectrum of experiences, facing each moment with courage, openness, and determination to respond in a way that aligns with our deepest values and principles. Courage to change. In our journey through the depths of Stoicism, we come to a fundamental truth that resonates with an almost mystical power: the acceptance of the flow of life. Picture yourself by a river, watching the water flow. There are moments when it runs freely and swiftly, and others when it moves slowly, almost stopping. Similarly, life presents us with a rich and varied tapestry of experiences, joys and sorrows, gains and losses, encounters and farewells. But what happens when we embrace this flow, accepting it not as an adversary, but as a guide? This acceptance is not an act of resignation, but a powerful release. It allows us to face reality with dignity and courage, armed with the wisdom that, while we may not control every aspect of our lives, we have complete mastery over how we choose to react to them. Consider this for a moment. How often do we wear ourselves out trying to shape life in our image, fighting against inevitable currents, instead of learning to navigate its waters with skill and grace? And here, my friends, lies the essence of courage in Stoic thought: the courage to change. Courage, as the Stoics teach us, is not the denial of fear, but the conscious decision to move forward despite it. It is the recognition that, while the future may seem uncertain and sometimes frightening, we possess within us the strength to face whatever lies ahead. But how do we cultivate this courage? It begins with small steps, with the decision to confront those things we avoid out of fear. It can be as simple as starting a new hobby, expressing a long-held feeling, or making a decision that has been postponed. Every action we take, despite fear, is an act of courage that builds our inner strength piece by piece. So I invite you to reflect: where in your life are you resisting the natural flow of things out of fear of change? And more importantly, where can you begin to apply the courage to change, to truly take the reins of your response to life's vicissitudes? Remember, the Stoics remind us that while we may not choose all the circumstances life presents us with, we always have the choice of how we respond to them. Accepting the flow of life and embracing the courage to change are powerful steps not only towards Stoic tranquility, but also towards a richer and more meaningful life. If you're enjoying this, don't miss out on the opportunity. Purchase the ebook now, Stoicism in the 21st Century, Ancient Strategies for Modern Challenges, and unlock your prosperity, abundance, and improve your relationships with this ebook. Link in the pinned comment. Gratitude for life. In our journey through this existence, we encounter an undeniable truth. Life is a rushing river full of twists and turns, rapids, and occasionally calm waters. Embracing this natural flow with all its ups and downs is an art that, once mastered, sets us free. This acceptance empowers us to face reality with grace and bravery. Aware that while we may not have power over every aspect of life, we are sovereign over how we react to it. Picture yourself by that river. You can choose to fight against the current, exhausting yourself in an attempt to control the uncontrollable. Or you can choose to skillfully navigate, adjusting the sails as needed. This metaphor reflects the Stoic wisdom of accepting the flow of life, embracing each experience with an open heart and a resilient mind. It's not about resignation, but a profound understanding that the nature of life is to fluctuate and that our power lies in our response to these fluctuations. In this context, courage takes center stage. Courage, as the Stoics teach us, is not the absence of fear, but the decision to move forward despite it. It's the strength that propels us to change what is within our reach, facing our fears directly and fearlessly. It can be the courage to speak the truth, to follow a new path, to let go of what no longer serves, or simply to rise after a fall. Essentially, it's the courage to be vulnerable, to be authentic, and to live fully, even when the path ahead seems uncertain. And where does gratitude fit into this panorama? Gratitude is the golden thread that weaves the tapestry of our lives, transforming our perspective and enriching our existence. It teaches us to appreciate the beauty and preciousness of each moment, to recognize the abundance we already possess. Practicing gratitude is opening our eyes to the everyday wonders that sometimes go unnoticed. The smile of a friend, the serenity of a sunset, the hidden lesson in a challenge. It's an invitation to celebrate life in all its forms, recognizing that even on the darkest days, there are sparks of light to be found. Thus, as we contemplate these principles, the acceptance of the flow of life, the courage to change, and the practice of gratitude, we are invited to live more richly and meaningfully. Each of these elements, while powerful on its own, gains an even greater dimension when intertwined with the others, forming a mosaic of wisdom that can guide our journey. Legacy of virtue. At the heart of Stoic philosophy, we find an invitation to reflect on the true meaning of legacy. Far from being a matter of fame or accumulated wealth, the Stoics teach us that our most authentic legacy resides in the quality of the life we lead, in the daily decisions we make, and in the virtue we diligently cultivate. But what does it truly mean to leave a legacy of virtue? How can we live in a way that, when we look back, we feel proud of the path we have walked, regardless of how the world chooses to see us? Living according to our truest values is a challenge that demands courage, introspection, and an unwavering commitment to authenticity. In a world that often values the external over the internal, staying true to our principles may seem like a lonely journey. However, it is precisely this fidelity to our values that forges a lasting legacy of virtue. Imagine for a moment that each choice you make, each action you undertake, is a stone you place in the building of your life. Some of these stones may be more flashy, capturing the attention of passers-by, while others may seem modest, almost imperceptible. However, it is the sum of these choices, of these daily acts of virtue, that builds the structure of a truly meaningful legacy. But how can we ensure that we are living according to our deepest values? The answer lies in the constant practice of reflection and the courage to make adjustments to our course when necessary. It is a process of continuous evaluation, of asking ourselves, do these choices reflect who I truly am and what I value? Am I contributing to the greater good, not just for myself, but for others around me? Furthermore, cultivating a legacy of virtue is not an act of selfishness, but of generosity. By living our lives with integrity, we become beacons of light for those around us, inspiring them to also seek their own truths and to live by them. It is a virtuous cycle, where virtue begets more virtue, and the impact of our lives extends far beyond our physical existence. Living according to nature. Imagine for a moment that you're walking along a serene trail in the forest, surrounded by the singing of birds, the whispering of leaves, and the refreshing sensation of clean air. This deep connection with nature is something that instinctively makes us feel alive, fulfilled, and at peace. But have you ever wondered how we can bring that feeling into our everyday lives, even outside of this idyllic setting? Living according to nature is not just a poetic concept, but a call to a more authentic and true existence. It means looking inward, recognizing and embracing our true essences, limitations, and capabilities. But what does that really imply in practice? How can we harmonize our lives with this powerful and transformative philosophy? First and foremost, it's about authenticity. In an era dominated by social media and constant pressure to present ourselves in a certain way, being authentic can seem like a challenging task. But think about it. How many times have you felt exhausted from trying to fit into others' expectations? Acting according to our deepest principles and values not only frees us from these constraints, but also allows us to live more fully and satisfactorily. Now you might be wondering, how can I start living according to my own nature? Start with small steps. Take a moment of your day to reflect on what you truly value, what brings joy and purpose to your life. This exercise in introspection is the first step to recognizing your true nature and aligning your actions with it. Moreover, living in harmony with the external nature reminds us of the importance of taking care of our planet, our common home. Sustainable practices such as reducing plastic consumption, recycling, and opting for a more plant-based diet are concrete ways to respect and preserve the environment. Have you noticed how these actions, besides being beneficial for the Earth, make us feel good and at peace with our consciences? Finally, and perhaps most importantly, living according to nature is a journey of self-love and acceptance. Recognizing our limits and potentials allows us to embrace our complete humanity with all its imperfections and beauties. And by doing so, we open the doors to a life richer in meaning and connection. And so, are you ready to embark on this transformative adventure? If this video resonated with you, I invite you to subscribe to the channel, leave your comments sharing your own journeys and reflections, and of course, to like this video. Together, let's explore even further this path of personal and collective growth. May you all be with the Creator.